One morning, George and Steve were chatting. George had been mocked about being in love with Katie and wanted to talk to Steve about it.
I sometimes wish the other engines would stop mocking me. I mean, I don't shove it down everyone's throats that I like her.
Yeah, well, some engines just don't believe in dating.
You're telling me. Charlie won't stop acting like it's blocking me from doing work. Like, really, it's...
Oh, don't even get me started, George. Yesterday, while you and she were having some alone time, I was stuck pulling coal trains. Were you two kissing? I wouldn't be surprised. Engine love is a whole pile of scrap. It shouldn't exist.
Well, he's not the only one who's fallen in love with a... another engine.
Huh? Oh, yeah. I do remember you mentioning that you fell in love with Cora. Why don't you tell us about how it went?
Here we go again.
Well, let's begin, shall we?
Cora was waiting at the junction for Steve to pass through.
This is ridiculous. Steve should have been here 10 minutes ago. What's taken him so long?
At that moment, Steve rounded the corner at last.
Sorry! Cora, I'm so sorry. There was a cow on the line, and I couldn't do anything to get her off until the farmer took her away, and you can go now.
It's okay, Steve. It's not like you broke something I value. I wonder why he freaks out like that whenever he makes a mistake around me.
Oh man.
Oh, yeah. Steve, good lord. You look like you just saw the devil himself.
Sorry. I was just worried that I was gonna let Cora down.
I could hear it from here. 10 minutes is not the worst thing in the world. In fact, I predict that within 40 years from now, whatever passenger trains we have will run much later than that.
I appreciate your humor, Martin, but I still don't want to lose my chances. If I do something that embarrasses her, what if she'll never want to, you know, be with me?
Oh, calm down. You worry too much, Steve. Believe me, you'll know when the time is right.
If you say so.
To be honest, I'm more concerned about what the others will think.
Come on. I know you've got some sort of secret that you're bottling up. What is it? What is it?
Nothing. It's nothing. Nothing. Why would you think it's something when it's nothing?
Could it be that you have a crush on Cora?
Okay, who told you that?
Ah, so I was right. I figured it out all by myself.
Oh, you can't be serious. An engine having a crush?
This is why I didn't want to tell you.
I can't believe engines actually think dating is a good thing. It gets in the way of work. We run railways, which means transporting important goods. How can you do that when you're running around smooching engines, which should be impossible? You, sir, are making a mistake.
And why do you care about it so much? Maybe you're jealous because he's pursuing someone and you're single.
I would never be jealous of such smuts. Dating is vulgar. Good day, you two.
You see what I mean?
I mean, it's not the end of the world.
Don't tell anyone, okay? Gosh!
Dating? Why'd I have to be dating, of all things?
So, what do y'all think? He's got a little crush.
That explains a lot.
Correct me if I'm wrong, but isn't it illegal for engines to date?
Technically, no, but it is frowned upon by many.
I really don't think we should get too hectic into this snooey-woogie-whiff stuff. It's just...
Alright, what's going on here?
Well, I was just telling these boys. Now it's your turn. Steve has a crush on Cora.
How did you find out?
Oh, I managed to get him to break down and confess it.
You little brat! If you tell anyone else, I'm gonna rewire your personality!
How could you do that?
Amy, do not speak of this to anyone, understand?
Well, he has to tell her at some point, before it's too late.
Too late indeed. What's the worst that could happen?
Wow, he looks like a charmer.
Hello, fellow engines. Mind if I stay here for a few days? I'm a private engine from the Nickel Plate Road. Mr. Jackson agreed to let me visit for a while.
Nice to meet you. Allow me to introduce myself. My name is Andrew. However, most just call me Andy for short.
Ah, nice to meet you, Andy. You may know me as NKP-759, but I do have a name, Harvey. Might as well meet your friends, too.
Cora Quinn. What's yours?
It's Harvey, but you can call me Prince Charming.
Okay then, Prince Charming. You're a Berkshire? Where are you from?
I'm from the Nickel Plate Road, as my tenor says. You appear to be a Chicago, Burlington, and Quincy E5A?
Huh, I didn't realize engines like me were famous.
You like to go fast, don't you?
Yeah, I like going fast. I'm a passenger diesel, so I kind of have to go fast to stick to the timetable.
Guess that makes two of us then. You know, I was built to run on fast freights, and sometimes I go so fast I make other engines jealous, if you catch my drift.
Well, that's, pretty cool, I must say. I'm sorry, but I have to get to my train.
Call me.
How can she call you? She doesn't have hands.
Hush, Andy. I think I've just found myself a very beautiful girlfriend.
Girlfriend? He only just met her. Ugh, I can't believe I just saw that. I don't think Steve's gonna like this.
Unfortunately, later that day when Harvey met Cora again, Steve was there too.
Hello again, my dear Cora.
Hello again, Prince Charming.
So, how was your journey? Adventurous?
Well, I just took my passengers to the end of the line. A few of them said thank you for the ride, and...
Ah, splendid. Well, I'm sure they enjoyed it after riding behind a beautiful, sleek diesel like you.
You're too kind.
Later that day, Steve came to find Andrew in the yard.
Hi, Steve. How are you?
Honestly, kind of heartbroken right now.
Steve explained to Andrew what he witnessed earlier that day, but it only angered Andrew.
Are you friggin' kidding me? You, Steve, getting worked up over a girl? Get a hold of yourself. You can't seriously be falling for that creep. Man up. I can't believe I'm hearing this garbage from you.
I can't believe I heard this from you. I thought you'd stick with me.
Meanwhile, Cora was doing her best to avoid Harvey. But at the same time, she had to carry on with her work, and unfortunately, she couldn't completely avoid it. As a compromise, she either ignored him and pretended to like him, even though he was really starting to creep her out. One night, however, the final straw was broken.
Hey, babe. Had a long day, didn't you?
Yeah, I guess. But it wasn't any different from any other day.
Yeah, routine work gets tiring, and sometimes it gets a little boring, doesn't it?
Well,
every once in a while, I would get bored with just running fast freights through Indiana. I love balloon excursion trains as well, but even that gets boring. And I don't like being bored.
What's that creep up to now?
Listen, Harvey, I do like you. I'm sure you're a reliable engine. But I really don't like it when you call me babe. I need to make this clear. We're not in a relationship, and steam engines aren't really my type.
Oh, don't give me that. I have heard that line before. I have even heard it from a few diesels. But I found a way to change their minds through a little thing I like to call persuasion. Suppose you've heard of a one-night stand, have you?
Okay, no, no, that's it! 759, I mean Harvey, I'm calling you out!
What are you talking about?
I know what you've been playing at, Harvey. My sisters in Chicago happen to know you, and they've told me about some stories where you had done this in the past.
Oh, come on, darling. I was just...
No! Don't even try to guilt trip your way out of this. Where do you think you get off where you can just seduce and make out with whatever engine looks good to you? That, in short, is what I've summarized about you. You use that suave, charming voice and claims for being a fast freight engine in a Berkshire to win the girls over just so you can have one night stand? And then when one night stand is over, you leave and move on to the next engine if you think you can play for a fool. Do you just assume you can get whatever you want and get anybody to like you just by using a suave voice and a few trophies?
Well, it's worked before.
That kind of thinking is pathetic and disgraceful, and that ends here and now. I can tell you for a fact that relationships don't work like that. You don't force women to like you just because of a few records like being fast or being strong or looking good or sounding good. I couldn't give a damn at all at this point, even if you were a sole survivor. I would rather be with somebody who has gained my trust and treats me like a real engine rather than with a womanizing creep like you. And I know what you're about to say, Harvey. Oh, all I wanted was to be in a relationship. You know what? I know I said steam locomotives weren't my type, but if you treated me with respect and treated me like a real engine rather than assuming I would like you for what you are, I might have changed my mind. Steve!
I have to keep myself going somehow when I'm on the road, and I'm going to get what I came here for, whether you like it or not.
Oh, you sure as hell won't.
What the heck? What's going on?
What's going on is, I'm going to drag you out of this yard, away from Cora, who has no interest in a creeper like you, might I add. And you're going all the way to Chicago with me.
What's going to happen to me in Chicago?
I have some friends up in Chicago I'd like you to meet. Or, should I say, some old acquaintances you might be familiar with. You do realize I'm a Santa Fe 3776 class, right? Yeah, don't even think about trying to fight me. Alright, get moving, you creepy little Berkshire.
It's okay, Cora. Calm down. It's over now.
Morning came very quickly. And before she even realized, Steve was back again next to her.
Hi, Cora. Can we talk?
I honestly could use someone to talk to right now. Especially after what happened to me last night.
Really? What happened to you?
It's Harvey. He's been hitting on me over and over ever since he arrived. I never wanted to admit it, but he was making me extremely uncomfortable. I'm so glad he's not here now.
Cora's wrong. Cora doesn't like him. That's for me, but when confessing that I like her, it would be a really good time. I'd make her even more upset.
To be honest, I was beginning to get the sinking feeling that you were liking him too.
What? Why?
Because he was calling you, my dear Cora, and your reply was Prince Charming, and I thought something was going on at that point.
No. I only called him that because he wanted me to. I had no feelings for him at all.
That's terrible. I'm so sorry you had to go through that, guy. I mean, this might be a really bad time to confess my own feelings, but I...
You like me too?
Yeah. I'm sorry that you know that. But please, I'm...
Thank heavens, I never even realized that. Oh, thank you, Steve.
You're not mad at me?
Steve, you've proved that you actually care about me for who I am. That Berkshire barely showed any restraint. I don't even know if I want to tell you what he tried to do last night.
And it shouldn't matter now. Mr. Jackson and I have sent Harvey away for good. He won't be coming back. Oh, and, Steve, I'm sorry for snapping at you. It's just, I didn't want to get involved with any romance again in my life.
Why?
It's because I haven't had much luck myself with trying to get a girlfriend. Let me explain. When my class of engine was built in 1941, my brothers and I didn't take long to figure out the advantages of having a girlfriend. We saw other engines on the railroad that had girlfriends, and we quickly realized the advantages of having one. We couldn't resist the urge of just having that feeling about carrying somebody in that way. Once a few of our class members got girlfriends, it didn't take long for the ripple effect to happen across the entire class, and soon everybody wanted to get a girlfriend. And almost every engineer in my class got a girlfriend. Except me, for some reason. Now, that isn't to say that I didn't try, per se. I asked out about a dozen engines when I was on the Santa Fe. But each time I asked, the same basic response I got was, "You're not my type." I don't know if it was to do with the fact that I was a Santa Fe engine, or a 484, or what, but for some reason, I just wasn't their type. To be fair, the reason I didn't ask out more girls is because I didn't get around much outside of the Santa Fe. Eventually, over time, and especially after a, incident, I just compromised and figured I wouldn't have to worry about ever finding a girlfriend again. And in 1958, when I was retired and when I was purchased by Mr. Jackson, I just gave up altogether. What I wanted was a girlfriend that was a steam engine, but seeing as steam was dead on the Santa Fe and pretty much everywhere else, I just figured I'd never see another active steam engine again. And whenever I see somebody else that's in a relationship, I get... How do I explain this? I get jealous, but it's not out of anger per se, it's just out of sadness, because... It's not that I want the girl that he's with, I just want to be in a relationship. I think I know what love is, and I know how to stay committed to a relationship. I just want to have that chance to show that I can be that guy. But, with my luck, you know, I just got a feeling that's not going to happen. That's not to say I don't think you two are meant to be in a relationship. In fact, would helping other engines accept your relationship be able to make up for me being so angry at you?
It will indeed.
Excellent. And, congratulations to you two.
You see, Charlie? There's nothing wrong with engines being in relationships.
Right, but how come it was wrong for, that Berkshire to want her, if you don't mind me asking?
You've got a lot to learn about relationships, Charlie.
Indeed he does. Now, how's it been with you and Katie?
Pretty good. Lucky for us, we do have the time to chat and catch up with each other while we do our work at the same time.
And once again, Charlie had a lot to think about for himself.